How to get rid of keto rash, it's also known under the name Prurigo Pigmentosa. This dermatologist will explain the latest updates concerning the Keto Rash Cure or Keto Rash Treatment.
Please like and subscribe. Thank you.
The Keto Rash or Prurigo Pigmentosa, also referred to as Nagashima's disease, is a rare inflammatory skin condition of unknown etiology. It typically presents as pruritic erythematous papules, papulovesicles and vesicles appearing in a reticular pattern on the back, chest or neck. In a previous video that I will link under this one, you can learn more about the keto rash and the link with the keto diet. In this one, we'll talk about the treatment options. If prurigo pigmentosa appears in a patient that recently started the keto diet, the increase of dietary carbohydrate intake can stop further worsening of the disease. Topical and systemic corticosteroids are not effective for prurigo pigmentosa. Oral minocycline is usually the first-line therapy for prurigo pigmentosa. However, doxycycline, macrolide antibiotics and/or dapsone may be indicated for some patients. Dosage of minocycline for this indication is 100 mg twice a day. Doxycycline at a dosage of 100 mg a day can be an alternative. Recently, macrolide antibiotics such as erythromycin have also been demonstrated to be helpful. Macrolide antibiotics have anti-inflammatory as well as antibacterial effects. Dosages are erythromycin 500 mg given twice a day, clarithromycin 400 mg daily and 300 mg of roxithromycin daily. Tetracycline antibiotics and dapsone are effective in treating prurigo pigmentosa during the inflammatory phase of the disease. These treatments are thought to work by interfering with the movement and function of neutrophils. Dapsone or diaminodiphenylsulfone (DDS) is an antibiotic used in various skin conditions and autoimmune diseases. Since it can cause some serious adverse effects, such as hemolysis and toxic hepatitis, in most cases it is not a first choice of treatment. Often used dosages are 150 mg dapsone per day. For many years, scientists attempted to develop a topical formulation of dapsone that would be as effective as oral dapsone but without the hemolysis side effect. This was difficult to accomplish because dapsone is highly insoluble in aqueous solvents. In February 2016, the FDA approved a 7.5% dapsone gel. This has the advantage of a once-daily application without causing clinical significant declines in hemoglobin levels. This could be tried in prurigo pigmentosa. In the literature, several case reports describe treating prurigo pigmentosa successfully with low-dose isotretinoin. Dosages of 0.3 mg per kilogram per day, 20 mg per day for most people, resolved all erythematous macules and papules after 3 months of treatment. Scientists concluded that low-dose isotretinoin is not only adequate for the improvement of erythematous lesions, it also helps resolve the reticular hyperpigmentation of prurigo pigmentosa. To date, there are no effective treatments for the hyperpigmentation that develops in the later stages of the disease. Topically, creams and gels with hydroquinone can be tried next to fruit acid peels or chemical peels or laser therapy. However, this post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation can be very resistant to treatment. Thanks for watching. Please leave your questions or comments under this video.